Welcome to the Cardano Convo Podcast weekly news segment for the week of September 13th, 2021. This podcast segment is where we try to summarize many of the happenings within the Cardano ecosystem and provide a quick and precise breakdown of these events. In this week's episode, we'll be covering a new partnership between Vi Finance and ADAX, another Charlie 3 partnership, smart contracts on Cardano, Emergo's new venture, KubeCoin, updates on the Ardana Stake Pool Alliance, the Cardano Summit in Wyoming, and more. Also, make sure to stay till the end for a couple of special announcements. Before we begin, I want to thank our sponsors. First are our Patreons over on the Cardano Convo Patreon page. Their direct contributions help to make this podcast possible. By becoming a Patreon, you gain amazing benefits such as access to polls that help decide the content of upcoming episodes, early access to videos, roles and benefits within the Discord server, and so much more. Lastly, we'd like to thank those delegating to Loop's pool. If you're looking for a way to help out the podcast and are looking for a Cardano stake pool to delegate your ADA to, then think about delegating with Loop's pool. That's Loop's, L-O-O-P-S, pool. Again, we'll begin this week's news segment by talking about new partnerships. This week, we'll begin with the strategic partnership between Vi Finance and ADAX. Just like previous news updates, I'll quickly cover what Vi Finance and ADAX are, followed by what this partnership entails. First, we'll start with Vi Finance. Vi Finance is an original interpretation of a decentralized exchange, or DEX, built upon four main pillars. These pillars are a liquidity aggregator, neural net, bar, and a learning management system. To learn more about Vi Finance, make sure to check out episode 1 where we talk with Jack Cochin, the marketing director of Vi Finance. Next is ADAX. ADAX is a state-of-the-art decentralized exchange built on Cardano. ADAX aims to bring a refreshing take on the traditional DEX and aims to bring a new and exciting experience to its users. For this and many more reasons, ADAX is being described by many as the Uniswap of Cardano. To learn more about ADAX, make sure to check out episode 3 where we talk with Dovidis, the chief marketing officer, and Mate Toke, a strategic advisor for ADAX and co-founder of Bitcoin.com. In this case, this partnership is relatively straightforward. Vi Finance will be hosting an ADAX/ADA liquidity pool on their platform, and ADAX will be hosting a ViFi/ADA liquidity pool on their platform. As I have said many times, when it comes to DEXs, liquidity is key. The more liquidity a DEX has, the better off it is with regards to resilience and many other factors. Now, moving on to our next partnership, we have MatrixSwap and Charlie3 strategic partnership. For those who have been listening to our news segment for the last couple of weeks, you may have heard of Charlie3 before, though I'll be covering both projects before getting to the meat of the partnership. First up is Charlie3. Charlie3 is, in short, a Cardano-based oracle. What Charlie3 does is pull data from APIs and provides this data to other decentralized applications, also called DApps, or other blockchain platforms. This usable data can range from the value or prices of different digital assets, or it can be used to accurately pull other data, such as weather conditions in different parts of the world. To learn more about Charlie3, make sure to check out episode 6 where we talk with Damon, the chief marketing officer, and Robert, the chief operating officer. Next is MatrixSwap. MatrixSwap is a decentralized, virtual automated market maker-based perpetual swap trading protocol deployed on the Polkadot, Cardano, and Polygon blockchain. Though, unlike traditional AMMs, users can long or short any asset's perpetual contract with up to 25x leverage. As we have explained previously, Charlie3 is an oracle that can provide pricing data for DApps. In this case, MatrixSwap will be relying on Charlie3 to provide accurate and trusted price data for the assets on MatrixSwap. This is especially important when MatrixSwap is providing future exchange functionalities. This importance was noted in MatrixSwap's project lead Joseph Leo's statement, quote, "The accuracy of Oracle price feed is one of the most important foundations of MatrixSwap protocol. We're thrilled to be working with Charlie3 as the main Oracle provider for our Cardano deployment. The team at Charlie3 have proven themselves to be the early pioneers in the Cardano ecosystem, and we look forward to a long and fruitful relationship with them," end quote. Again, Charlie 3's functionalities are relatively versatile, and many projects are going to need an oracle to provide necessary data. Thus, we can all look forward to seeing more partnerships cropping up in the future for Charlie 3. Now, let's move on to some smart contract news. In last week's news segment, we talked about how Ben and Tim of IOHK stated that there were over 30 smart contracts running within the first 30 minutes of the Alonzo hard fork. Well, within the first 24 hours, there were over 100 smart contracts running on the Cardano blockchain. I know I keep bringing this up every week, but this is history in the making. I'm sure that in a year from now, it'll be taken for granted that Cardano has smart contract functionalities and DeFi platforms built on it. Though for many of us who have been in this space since before the Shelley era, when you couldn't stake, this is another amazing development. On the topic of smart contracts and DeFi, there was an announcement on September 16th from Emergo, the official commercial arm of Cardano. In this announcement, we learned that Emergo teamed up with a Chinese-based technology firm, Blockchain4A, to form a starter. A starter is a DeFi infrastructure hub on Cardano backed by Emergo. A starter is going to build a launchpad, decentralized exchange, money market, and tech service dApps on the Cardano blockchain. In short, it looks like Emergo is going to be giving a lot of Cardano projects a run for their money, especially if they can pull off all the listed components of its ecosystem. So let's cover some of them. First, let's talk about the launchpad. The launchpad will allow seed and early stage startups to raise capital and garner marketing support from the Cardano ecosystem. The Astarter launchpad will offer support for full KYC integration, token sales, governance voting, tiered offerings, and permissionless listings. The second component of Astarter is their DEX. Now, I know, and I'm sure many of you know, that projects always aim to have their name be a play on the word Cardano or ADA. Well, Astarter is no different, but their name is extremely similar to another DEX. Astarter's DEX is ADEX. ADEX is very similar to ADAX, so I wonder how that will work out. ADEX will be fully equipped to support Cardano users with wallets, price feed transactions, market displays, and decentralized lending. ADEX plans to offer both fast and secure support that lowers the DeFi world's barrier to entry. Also, ADEX aims to provide accurate DEX data by making trading volume transparent and verifiable. Finally, there won't be a KYC requirement. The third component is their money market or decentralized marketplace for borrowing and lending. Through the use of smart contracts and Astarter vaults, digital assets can be accepted as collateral for loans. Anyone will be able to use this platform to retain complete ownership of their funds as long as collateral to loan ratio stipulations are met. The Astarter money market will be fully decentralized, anchored one-to-one with USD, and backed by on-chain assets. The fourth and final component is the tech service platform. This tech service platform will help to service many platforms or projects that work with smart contracts. Some will need oracles, as stated previously, and Astarter plans to offer a unified general data protocol so that there is consistency with the way that off-chain data is being fed on-chain. In addition to this function, Astarter's diverse tech service platform delivers a robust offering of resources to further the user experience on Cardano. The user experience is simple with a feature that allows smart contracts to be generated with just the touch of a button. Overall, this is definitely a competitor to be on the lookout for. It also seems a little too soon to see how this will stack up to other projects within the space. With that said, do you think that Astarter is going too wide for what it plans to create, or can it accomplish its goals to produce all of these components? Let us know in the comments below. There is also the option that due to the many partnerships and projects that are working together in some capacity, that they may easily be able to outcompete Astarter. Who knows? Now, let's move on to some news on a pre-sale that is coming up for a unique project. It is a project that we interviewed and we will be releasing a video this week. So make sure to follow the podcast and follow us on Twitter to see when that goes live. Though, before I go into the pre-sale news, I want to preface it. We here at the Cardano Convo podcast cover many different projects and platforms. We do so to try and help the community learn about these projects and have the opportunity to do more research on them. One shouldn't assume because we interviewed a project that we are endorsing or advocating for that project. We want to inform you about pre-sales so that you can do your due diligence and decide for yourself what to do. We aren't financial, legal, or tax advisors, so we won't and can't give such advice. If you are looking for financial, legal, or tax advice, seek out a licensed professional. Now that we have gotten that out of the way, let's continue on the project and pre-sale. The project that we have recently interviewed is KubeCoin, with Cube starting with a K. KubeCoin describes itself as, quote, the digital currency that aims to revolutionize the leisure and travel industries, universally adoptable through multi-brand platforms, built on Cardano, end quote. Their pre-sale of their KubeCoin token will be taking place on September 27th. If you head to their website at KubeCoin.org, you will see a timer in the top right corner informing you of when the pre-sale goes live. On top of that, to purchase the token, you must complete the KYC process, and this seems to be available to Americans as well. Lastly, as we have previously stated, we have done an interview with Paolo, the CEO of KubeCoin. We aim to release this episode on Wednesday the 22nd. The first announcement I have is about the Cardano summits. I just wanted to give a heads up to all of my listeners. There are many Cardano summits going on around the world this coming week, but I wanted to let you all know that I will be making a 12-hour plus drive to the Wyoming summit. I'll be wearing a Cardano Convo podcast shirt that will be linked on our social medias when they arrive. If you are heading to the Wyoming summit, don't be shy. Feel free to jump on in and start some convos with us. I'm sure it'll be a very interesting event, and I know that there will be other members of the Cardano community there as well, including Chris, the founder of Cardania, Raymond, the stake pool operator of Grow Pool, and many others. I look forward to learning a lot at the summit so that I can bring that news back to you guys and to meeting the community in person. Lastly, I wanted to provide a Loops Pool update / announcement. In last week's episode, we said that we were aiming to join the Ardana Stake Pool Alliance, or ASPA. And today I can happily inform our delegators and community that we are a part of the ASPA. Their goals line up with ours, and we believe that not only can we benefit the ASPA and the Cardano community, but that the ASPA can help benefit the Cardano community as well. Again, thank you all for supporting the Loops Pool, and thank you Ardana for accepting us into the Alliance. Thank you for joining us for this week's Cardano News on the Cardano Convo podcast. If you want an easy way to help us out, make sure to share this podcast. That way we can grow and create a better podcast for you guys. Also leave us a 5-star review. And if you had feedback on today's episode, tweet us at Cardano Convo. Send your emails to cardanoconvo@gmail.com or join the Cardano Convo Discord server and let us know. We'd love to hear from you. Also, make sure to check out our new podcast website on crypto-loops.com. Again, thank you for joining us, and we'll see you in the next episode of the Cardano Convo.